It's a battle. On one side, three floors of student digs, now bereft of life, with no future prospects. On the other, members of the School of Hard Knocks. With 48 tons of excavator ready to hand out a permanent expulsion. As the grab breaks into the top story, driver Ford Marshall must keep on high alert if he's to spot and extract any hidden gems within.
Bit of copper for boss. There'll be plenty more of that to come out.
With the firm hoping for a scrap haul of 20 grand, even the most unlikely items are worth saving.
Old bath. How did it know students washed?
As the walls come away, Ford can size up the considerable task ahead.
Well, I can see in the building now. See what we're up against.
And it's clear that the makeup of the halls is far from ideal.
It's always a bit messy when you're breaking into a building like this.
As the skip arrives on a tight deadline to shuttle materials away for processing, Boss Pete is back to ensure every last penny can be reaped and, crucially, prevent it from falling into the hands of thieves.
We've got scrap. That's what we want. We love a bit of scrap. We like this even better. Gold, as Pepe calls it. Pete's gold, bit of copper.
In the world of demolition, the scrap materials break down into the valuable and the downright expensive.
Wood isn't so bad. We can send that at a relatively low cost for shredding for biomass fuel. This is what we don't want, is waste. This is what we're not looking for. This is £120-130 a tonne to get rid of.
One crucial metal must be extracted to help offset the mounting costs. High-grade steel is always welcome, and there's scrap to be had in student block 2.
We're just going to cut these railings out here off these stairs now. Bit of scrap to weigh in for Marquis.
Graham's stepping up to the task.
I'll get my safety gear on first. We don't want outgoing into eyes, do we, lads?
And the balustrades require his weapon of choice.
We'll clamp the old steel saw up, and we'll begin.
It's banister versus brawn. But the rails are more robust than Graham may have thought.
Yeah, it should go over that. It should go over. It won't fall off completely like it, but...
Outside, the block continues to crumble. Ford Marshall must tackle the roof. With materials falling from height, caution is paramount.
That's the roof off it anyway.
With the roof removed, the mound of debris is now too large to work around. So Ford is left with no choice but to slow down the pace.
There's more to the job than a lot of people think. It's not just a case of getting the building down, it's segregating the materials, what takes the time.
But not everyone enjoys the grueling task of sorting by hand.
If there's any manual work to be done, they all disappear or hide inside the buildings what are still standing.
Hey, up. I'll do. There's a shout at Brew Lobs.
But for Ford, this part of the job has the benefits of a PE lesson.
Sometimes it's good to get out and have a bit of exercise. It's not good being sat in these machines for 8 hours a day. Might have a bit of a stretch now and again.
And the manual segregation also provides a welcome separation from his partner in crime.
She's a good machine. I spend more time with this machine, though, than I do with the missus.
After a day of destruction, the constant money-making bout of waste versus scrap hangs in the balance. It's 4 weeks into the job, and two eager students of the art of demolition are on site. Labourers Ryan Gormley and Jack Myerscough. As the grab chomps away at the sides of the building, the next roof section looks vulnerable.
There's obviously a lot of strain at the top where it's going to dip down, and it won't even take that much pressure for it to just fully drop. It should be any moment now.
Sure enough, the pressure soon becomes too much.
Absolute cracking.
And that has repercussions for the boys.
But now we've got some picking to do. It's our time to shine. He's getting the final bits off now.
That's the final platform.
Final platform. Great. Then he'll bring the roof over.
And back from immersing himself in demolition history. Pete must refocus on the contemporary concerns of a current scrap king.
There's been quite a value of copper come out of it. We're just processing that at yard, that's due to go in. We'll just monitor price now and see if that goes up. But there's been somewhere in the region of about 3 tonne of copper in this job and brass, which if it does £5,000 a tonne, that's easy enough to work out. We didn't think there'd be much steel in it, but it'll have produced, we're banging on door of 100 tonne when it's finished. So again, it's a bit extra, you know. But all in all, the job's gone well. So far, so good, but don't count your chickens till they've hatched.
In the end, there were plenty of chickens for Pete to count, with the job hatching out a profit of over £25,000. The bulk of the students, though, will be continuing to survive on their overdrafts. Their old bedroom walls collapsed under the rubble. But in a matter of months, new family homes will emerge on site, built on the buried memories of Freshers' Week.